As we joked around, Tesla hasn't gone parabolic in like 3 weeks, right? You see this channel here, guys? The high here, the high here, the high here.
Welcome to AccessATrader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Hey guys, good evening everybody. Welcome to another edition, I think the Tuesday version of the AccessATrader.com nightly wrap-up show. Hope everybody doing well. So let's talk about it. So we talked about last night potential res day. Again, big moves. Again, nothing goes straight up, nothing goes straight down. We talked about yesterday the retail trade. You have to buy Apple in the event. You have to buy Apple to the event. You have to buy Apple to the event. Obviously, you have to buy Apple to the event. You got to keep buying Apple to the event. How can you not buy Apple to the event? Because, well, what happens is, again, like we said yesterday, any single time a trade is obvious and retail is involved telling you what you have to do, usually this is going to happen. That's exactly what happened. We'll get to that in a second. But with all the things that we talked about yesterday and a potential back test for the rest of the market, apparently, nobody told this to individual stocks. And again, today was one of the more aggressive trades you saw in the macro beta world, okay? And again, everything is kind of playing out in stages. If you guys remember a couple of weeks ago when we were looking at this top of the channel here, we were looking for stocks that coming out of the bottom ranges, right? Stocks that had a big run, kind of did nothing for about a 1 or 2 week, and then when they finally went up, that was the time to buy them. Again, like the Amazons of the world, the Apples of the world, the ZMs of the world. We'll get to ZM in a second. And now we're kind of to the point of those stocks that came out of those ranges, they don't care what the index is doing anymore. Like today, for example, the market was completely flat. The Dow was down 150 points. The NASDAQ down a little bit. They didn't care. Okay, right now we're at that point of FOMO is really real, okay, very, very aggressive. And what they're doing is the stocks that relaxed the previous day, for example, like a Roku, right? What they usually do is they're taking that stock that relaxed and putting all the money flow back into that name with aggressive option flow. And we're seeing that kind of over and over and over again. So kind of going into tomorrow's session, not to kind of jump around, but going into tomorrow's session, the stocks that we were talking about, for example, like a Zoom, right? The names that we were talking about out of a Zoom coming out of a really sneaky macro channel, now their conversation is, well, now they're about to attack the highs of the day. A stock, for example, like Netflix, right, came out of a really, really tight macro channel. Again, now we're talking about if the stock potentially, again, taking out 52-week highs. Same thing with crowd, right? This is the same trade over and over again, right? Coming out of macro channels, right? Tight sessions before the NASDAQ broke out, and now we're talking about 52-week highs. So the action is very, very bullish, and it's the same players over and over again. The FSLYs, the docus that got upgraded today after the close, spiking higher. The DDOGs, you got data, right? You got data, you got storage. You have the stay-at-home names. Again, Eli Lilly came out today in the middle of the day talking about the world. They're pausing some sort of drug or something to the extent. And again, does it really make a difference? And as soon as that news hit, you had the stay-at-home plays really explode. So if you look at the afternoon sessions, these stocks were hot to begin with, but Zoom exploded into the close, right? Netflix, again, exploded into the close, right? These are names that, again, have everything to do with the whole stay-at-home movement, and the longer that there is no drug or vaccine or anything else, these stocks are going to continue to do well because, again, that means the longer the economy is going to open up full-blown and people are going to go back to work. Again, is Docu here to stay? I think it is. This is a great company because more and more people are using them regardless if it's the stay-at-home movement or not. Is Amazon going to continue to benefit from everything in life? Of course. So again, the stay-at-home movement really doesn't affect them that much, but a stock like Zoom does, right? Zoom is the direct beneficiary of what's been going on, especially for the last 8-9 years. And again, the longer we see the economy not fully operational, the global economy operational, a stock like Zoom is going to benefit, and all the names in that group is going to continue to do very, very well. All you got to do is look at Peloton. And again, everybody, again, is looking for that magical reversal in Peloton. Again, If you would have told me 9 months ago this was going to be an advantageous play into the stay-at-home movement, again, I have a Peloton bike. I bought one 3 years ago. I've been on it five times. Best five rides I ever had, but I've been on it five times. So if you told me 8, 9 months ago this is going to do what this is doing now, I would never believe so. So the market is incredibly strong right now. What we saw, again, ranges confirmations 2 weeks ago are now leading to back to 52-week highs. And the moral of the story is the transition from one name to another is every single day. It's almost like a carousel ride. But when the option flow kicks in and you see that option flow get really, really aggressive, you usually have price action to follow 2, 3, 4 days later, and that's what we're seeing all around the market. So again, how can you not be bullish going into tomorrow's session, right? And again, I'm saying the same thing that I say every single day. I'm not looking to play stocks that are up 12 days in a row. I don't care about those stocks. I'm looking, again, for those names that are just coming out of a channel, either on a macro version or an intermediate level, again, within between the highs, the 52-week highs and the lows, or names have been kind of grinding above their ranges and now about to tack 52-week highs. That's what's been working. That's what the rotation money flow likes. That's what the power players are still continuing taking out of the money option bets on those names. So names like Apple, again, have no value for me right now. Maybe if it comes into a bounce area, into the five-day moving average here, yeah, sure, why not? You can entertain a bounce here. But again, there absolutely is no edge until it kind of starts confirming this little two-island setup, whatever it's called. Amazon, again, had a monster run. What do you want to do with this thing, right? Again, can this thing test 52-week highs eventually to this 35-50 level? Absolutely. But again, it needs rest, right? It definitely needs rest, 2, 3, 4 days left. We want to kind of see it attack this channel right here before it goes to 52-week highs. But again, if there is a market structure that's a value to your system, Amazon should be kind of dead money, which I'm hoping that's a good thing. It should be dead money for the next few days just for distribution to occur, just for sellers to be comfortable, okay, in the price levels. And eventually, when Amazon wakes up, and hopefully it'll be some point next week, it could have a test of the 52-week high. So again, let's talk about today's session. Very aggressive. You can see here, again, it's the same players over and over and over again. They're just taking out different levels. So let's talk about this. So Beyond gets downgraded this morning. And here are kind of my notes. 183, if it builds below, can flush more. Experienced traders only. And the reason why I say that, I go, look, keep in mind, there's no money on the short side. There really isn't. Okay, this stock has been really, really strong. There is no general selling pressure. So if you're going to trade this, trade it strictly for cash flow. And that's exactly what the stock did. Again, I don't think there's anybody here trying to turn around and say this market's going to hell in a handbasket. Maybe it will one day when the technicals break down, but it's not going to be now. And even if a stock gets downgraded, they still respect technical levels. And you can see the 10-day moving average got respected very quickly. So 83 was the pivot right here, 83, and it went to like 80 and change. Again, was it the biggest move in the world? But again, we're talking about strictly cash flow to the downside. Everything else were long pivots. Ironically, I got caught in this Apple move. I tried to bounce a very aggressive level, which I wasn't successful. I lost about like $1.40, $1.50 on a quarter size. But again, it was fine. There was nothing wrong with that. I think I jumped the gun a little bit on the level if I kind of reviewed my thought process. But again, I got caught in this a little bit. It's okay. Everything else worked out pretty well. DDOG was my next venture, 114.75, 115. DDOG continues to be really, really good. Big pop here off this 14.75, 15. Went to 18 and change. I think if it could reclaim this like 1820, 1850 level, I think it'll go higher. Again, the last line of defense for any type of supply is this linear regression line. So I still like it. I think it goes higher. mRNA went really nuts in the beginning. mRNA 76, 76 and a quarter needs to build. Here was mRNA, right? So here's the 76, 76 and a quarter. Stock went to almost 81 and a half. Big move there. Roku, again, what can you say? And again, here's my perfect example of a stock resting yesterday, okay? Did absolutely nothing yesterday. It looked like it was about to fall off the earth. And again, it held rising support that we continuously talk about, strong stocks into rising 60-minute support. And today, again, here's where we talk about sneaky channels. So here's Roku, right? Here was Roku. Here was the 124. Here's the, you see these two candles here, right? 124 was the supply here, 124 was the supply here, and again, here's the 124, and the stock absolutely went nuts. Went to 240, huge move. Again, it's just, if you stop using the smaller intervals, like the 1 and the 5 minute, and switch to the 60, you'll see this so clear. Because again, look at the 60 minute, right? Here's the 60 minute, here's the 224, again, rejected twice. Once it reclaimed, it just absolutely went nuts. So, definitely consider that. NET had a monster day yesterday. The notes pre-market, there's a bounce area coming around the 54.70s for experienced traders only, or the red to green potential. Not only did it hold that 70, look at the low of the day, right? Look at the low of the day, guys. 52.80s was the low of the day. It went red to green. The stock went up about 3 and change. So great job for all you guys who took that as well. Roku, big spike. Again, Beyond, take on the way down. Again, there's no selling pressure there. Roku, just a huge move on Roku. ZM, again, what are you going to say? The breakout was 490. We were highlighting that breakout for like 2 weeks. It broke 490, closed above 497. We knew the next big area was going to be that 508 area. And I said, look, if this thing can start confirming 508, needs to build for a possible test for macro 52-week highs, which I think is going to happen tomorrow. So here was ZM, right? Here was ZM. So it takes out this 508 area, right? Here's the 508, okay? It takes out the 508 and just absolutely explodes, goes to 520. And now you see what the 52-week high here is, just a huge move. And again, we have a puncher shot going to the 52-week highs. So good job, guys, for all you guys who are still holding that as well. Amazon, there was a cute little pivot, nothing big there. 381 needs to build to kind of wake up. Again, it wasn't a big move at all. So here was the 381. Let me just show you the 3181 area right here. It was right here, and it popped up, popped up about $11. And then obviously, again, it rolled over because it's going to roll over because it had already a big run. Remember, we're staying away from the Apple. We're staying away from the video. We're staying away from the stocks that have these monster runs until they start consolidating more and more and more. So again, that was strictly for a cash flow move. NET, again, exploding new highs. Tesla. I love Tesla going into tomorrow. It looks absolutely great. Again, if you look at Tesla's chart, and again, as we joked around, Tesla hasn't gone parabolic in like 3 weeks, right? You see this channel here, guys? The high here, the high here, the high here. It's exactly the same high. All it does, guys, it's a pretty basic setup here. All you got to do is look at the chart for the highs of the last 3 days in this whole channel for 3 weeks, and you can see what the pivot is, okay? Nobody needs to tell you what the pivot is. If it could clear out this whole channel here, we could see move right back to this linear regression line. We saw pretty big aggressive size call buyers coming in the 450 calls, the 460 calls, the 470 weeklies. So we are set up for tomorrow. Again, you don't need to be very creative. All we need to do is sit, wait for these confirmations on all these names. And once we get the green light, that's when we strike with extreme prejudice. If not, you don't anticipate. You don't try to guess. You wait for the number to confirm. Guys, have a great night, everybody. God bless. And I'll see you all tomorrow.